Hey, it's Professor Dave. Let's learn about absolute values.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
In our haste to get through algebra, there's one topic we didn't mention. So before we move on, let's quickly cover absolute values. It's important to know what these are and how to graph them. So let's become familiar with this definition. The absolute value of any real number, x, which is denoted by these little bracket-type things, is the distance from 0 to that number on a number line. Take the number 3. This is 3 units away from 0, so the absolute value of 3 is 3. Now look at negative 3. This is also 3 units away from 0, so the absolute value of negative 3 is 3. That brings us to a more practical definition of absolute value, as being the magnitude of a number disregarding its sign. Positive numbers are unchanged by taking the absolute value, while negative numbers simply drop the negative sign and become positive. This applies not just to integers, but all real numbers, whether rational or irrational. Absolute values obey properties just like other operations, so we can see that the absolute value of AB can be split up into the product of two absolute values, and the same goes for division. However, let's note that the absolute value of A plus B does not equal the absolute value of A plus the absolute value of B, which we can demonstrate with the values 1 and negative 1. We clearly don't get the same thing. When we encounter absolute values while solving equations, it just adds another step. If we have the absolute value of x equals 2, that means x could be 2 or negative 2, so there are two solutions to this equation. If we try a trickier one, like the absolute value of 2x minus 1 equals 5, then again, we split this up into two equations. It could either be the case that 2x minus 1 equals 5, or 2x minus 1 could equal negative 5, because once we take the absolute value, we get 5 either way. That means we now have to solve both of these equations to get the two possible values of x. For the first one, we add 1, divide by 2, and x equals 3. For the other, we do the same thing, but we get x equals negative 2. So those are the two solutions in this case. The equations can get harder than this, but the approach will always be the same. The last thing we want to do is look at simple graphs with absolute values. We know that a graph of y equals x will look like this. The x and y values at every single point are equal to one another, and it's just a line with a slope of 1 and a y-intercept of 0. Now, what if we want to graph y equals the absolute value of x? Well, as we said, all positive values remain unchanged, so everything from the y-axis to the right will be just like it is now. But negative values will have their signs reversed. When we plug in negative 1 for x, we don't get negative 1 for y, we get positive 1. Negative 2 gives us positive 2, and so forth. That means that everything to the left of the y-axis, or all the negative inputs for x, will be reflected across the x-axis, so that we get the positive versions of all these y-values, resulting in this V-shaped graph, rather than the line we had before. This can be transformed in all kinds of ways that we will learn later. For now, we just want to understand some basics about absolute values, what they are, and what they do. With that covered, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.